Hello, fifth and sixth grade students. Today we are all virtual, so we all need to watch this video. This is all about the bell ringer for this week, which is value. And I'll tell you off the bat, value is one of these tricky words. So please focus up here. I need you to be listening, because otherwise you're not going to get this. All right. When people hear the word value, they typically think about money, money, cash, money. How much is something valuable money-wise? However, in art, it has nothing to do with money. Value is the lightness and the darkness of a color. So for example, if I had the color red and I mixed black into it, it would be a dark value of red. Or if I had red and I mixed white into it, it would get lighter and another value of red. So they're all still red, but one's lighter, one's darker, okay? So if you scroll down into this bell ringer, you'll see this pretty brownish looking painting called The Potato Eaters. And this is actually done by Vincent van Gogh, which is surprising because normally Vincent van Gogh is known for his big swirly, whirly, colorful art, and we talked about it earlier this year actually, but this was one of his earlier pieces before he got into the big expressive type of style he does. So if you look at these potato eaters, my question has a couple different parts, so pay attention if you haven't already been paying attention. All right, this piece has a lot to do with value. Tell me, where in the painting is the lightest value? So literally tell me where it is the lightest thing. I find it's helpful when I talk about value is to actually squint my eyes so it blurs out the details so you can see light and dark a little easier. So if you do that, you squint your eyes, where is the lightest thing? Okay. Tell me what that object is. And then I also want you to squint your eyes and tell me what the darkest value is. Where's the darkest thing in this painting? Okay. So that's the first part, is telling me what those light and dark things are. And the second part that people usually forget is the why. Why is that the lightest thing? And why is that the darkest thing? And the biggest hint I can give you without totally giving you the answer is, where is the light coming from in this painting? And now I don't mean your computer screen, bright screen. I don't mean the lights in your room. I mean, where the light coming from in the painting, okay? So that will help tell you why something is the lightest and why something is the darkest, okay? So again, this is one of those that get really, really tricky, because if you weren't paying attention, you missed all that good juicy info that I just shared with you, okay? So I'm looking for lightest thing in that painting, darkest thing in that painting, and why, okay? A lot of people miss the why part, so don't forget it, all right? If you have questions, comments, concerns, let me know. I will happily let you know. You can send me an email or you can type a message to me in Google Classroom. But if you have any other questions, I am here waiting for them. So I'll talk to you soon, and I'll be talking to you about your project this week as well. All right. Happy typing, and we'll get creating very shortly after this.